Let us study about the parallel combination of resistances. In case of parallel combination, resistances are connected in such a way that of different resistances, the side terminals are connected to each other like this, which I am drawing here. Here you can see we are having three resistances R1, R2 and R3. If all the left terminals are connected together and all the right terminals of the resistances are connected together, then in this situation we see that resistances are connected in parallel combination. And to find its equivalent resistance, say if we connect a battery across the combination and say the battery is of EMF E, then in this situation a potential difference E will be applied across these three resistances in parallel. If on the right side we consider potential to be 0 volt, then on the left side, on the positive side, the potential will be E volt higher, so your potential will be E. Here you can see across all the three resistances, the potential difference remains the same. So if a current I flows through the battery to be supplied to the group of resistances, then this current will be divided into the three resistances as I1, I2 and I3. And finally, it will combine to produce the same current I as charge is conserved. In this situation, we know that the potential difference across the three resistances is same. So we can easily calculate these values of I1, I2 and I3 depending on the potential difference, which is the EMF of the battery. So in this situation, if we calculate the current in resistances, this can be directly given as I1 is equals to E by R1, I2 is equals to E by R2, and here I3 is equals to E by R3, because E is the potential difference, R is the resistance. So by Ohm's law, we can calculate the current through individual resistances. Now if we calculate the total current through battery, this can be given as I, which is equals to I1 plus I2 plus I3, because this current only is divided into the three resistances. Now in the situation, if we wish to find out the equivalent resistance for the combination, that will be the applied potential difference divided by the current supplied to the group, that is I. So we substitute the values, this I, E divided by I, which can be written as I1 plus I2 plus I3. Now in this situation, values of I1, I2, I3 we substitute from here. It will be E by R1 plus E by R2 plus E by R3. So here you can see this E gets cancelled out, and the value of R equivalent can be simplified by taking its reciprocal as 1 by R equivalent is equals to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. This is the way how we calculate the equivalent resistance for the group of a parallel combination of resistances. And with this logic, we can also state one thing, that in this situation, the potential difference across all resistances is same. And here we can see that R equivalent will be lesser than the least value of resistance in the situation, because reciprocals are added up. And say we just have a look on a realistic situation of parallel combination. Here you can see when current is supplied into the group, the current is divided among the three resistances and finally it becomes the same. So be careful that in case of parallel combination, current is divided among resistances, but the potential difference across all resistances remain the same.